Penny Morris, we food around with her.
Jenny Morris on Heart FM.
All right, we've got Jenny in her kitchen doing her things. Morning to you again, Ms. Jenny Morris.
Good morning. And look at my boy down there with that big red microphone in his face. And Tara, good morning.
Good morning.
You look a little blurry. You look a little blurry, Jenny.
And you're not. Am I blurry?
She looks a little blurry. She looks fine. Maybe your eyes aren't working so lekker.
Oh, maybe it's my eyes.
I'm sending you for eye test.
Lots of carrots. Listen, Jenny, is it true about carrots? I mean, the carrots really help with eyesight.
Well, the vitamin A content is beautiful and high, and you know, eyes need vitamin A. So, Julian, you're getting carrots, baby.
Okay. I actually don't mind carrots, eh? I love a carrot juice as well.
Ooh, it is very delicious, but you'll need a lot of carrots. You need to eat them every day, so just pop a pill. Pop a
include, pill. Include me out of the carrot juice. Not my vibe, not my thing. Anyway, so the second you tell people to make their own sauces, it's almost like, you know, something comes over them. They kind of glaze over and lose interest because people assume that making a sauce, be it a white sauce or making vinaigrette or just any of those kinds of things, are just a hang of a lot more complicated than they should be.
And they're not, you know, there are so many ways. I mean, it's easy to pop a packet and stick it in the pot and that's fine. But I think that you can still use good ingredients and get a stunning result. So, I mean, a sauce, we're not telling you to roast bones and cook them down and make a jus. All we're saying is just has a quick little white sauce, cheese sauce that you can use on pasta, on courgettes, on baby marrows, whatever you want to call these things. And broccoli and cauliflower, those are like kind of the common things that we use a white sauce on, or a nice little cheese sauce. So yeah,
and
easy peasy.
And when it comes to making any sauce, are there a couple of quick tips? I mean, before you get into this particular type of sauce, because sometimes people have they serve you a sauce that's a little lumpy. In some cases, there's some sauce, but I mean, there's just a hang of a lot of liquid. You know, where it's just too watered down, too little of the taste, and too much of the liquid. I mean, it's about maintaining a balance.
Yep.
To be consistent with what that sauce is meant to be doing.
Two tips. If you're making a gravy sauce, for instance, and exactly what you're saying, it's thin on flavor and it's too watery, you've got to reduce that down so the flavor concentrates. So always put it into a big pan and with a nice big surface so that it can evaporate very, very quickly and reduce down. Delicious and tasty. And I think one of the worst mistakes we make when we're doing like a white sauce or a cheese sauce, even a brown sauce, you say, oh, it's too thin. How am I going to thicken it? People start stirring raw flour into it. Just take equal quantities of butter and equal quantities of flour, and you mix it together and make a little dough ball. And I always have that in my freezer. And then you just stick little pieces in and stir until you get the consistency you want. That way it doesn't taste like raw flour.
Okay. I know people, they moor half a packet of Maizena into something thinking that the be-all and end-all. It's a thickening agent. It's a flavoring agent. I mean, No, but I mean, this is how people, when they make a sauce, there's just got to be a hang of a lot of Maizena to give it consistency.
I love it though. I love Maizena. You know why I love it is because if you're doing a sauce like a stir fry, sometimes I dilute just a little bit, the littlest bit on the side, with a little bit of soya sauce and water, and then I'm talking of my sauce is too watery with a stir fry because I want that to come in and just suck up all that flavor and get it to stick to that little chicken body or beef body and the veggies. So the littlest amount, it's a wonderful product to have, but you can't expect to get any flavor out of it. It does capture flavor and get it to stick to your food, but otherwise it's a globule.
All right. I'm going to slip away. I'm going to leave Tara, and Jules will rejoin in just a moment. They'll be chatting about the sauce. It's a sort of a cheat white sauce that Jenny's knocking together. If you've always wanted to, but have been a little shy, a little bit intimidated and so on, Jenny's going to give you some surefire ways of not stuffing this one up. Okay. So I'll rejoin in just a little.
Good morning, Leanne, Nakin. Good morning to you from all of us. And I just want to say, Tara, are you listening?
I am listening, and I'm very excited. I am so excited because all I see in front of you are vegetables. This is my morning.
It's your morning. It's your morning.
I'll sit back and watch.
Oh, really? You're going to love this cheat sheet.
Let's see.
You can add nyama to this. You can put chorizo. You can put bacon bits. You can add, this sauce is lovely on chicken. It's lovely on anything. So okay. Before we get chatting, I want to just get my cream into the pot. All this beautiful.
So that's just normal fresh cream?
Full cream. Full cream, not low fat. It's full fat cream. So that's going to go into the pot. Now, you can have any base to this. What I've done with the feta is I'm going to use a bit of black pepper, my special blend of white peppercorns, black peppercorns that I toast off in the pan, because I want that flavor, and some dry chili flakes, okay, because I want a little bit of oomph. And always I like a little bit of nutmeg. Not a lot, just the tiniest little bit, because I want to build a bit of depth into this sauce. So what we need, literally, look at that, 1, 2, and 3, done. And dust it. You can always taste it and balance it off again, okay? Cheddar cheese, you could do the same thing with it, but I love the feta thing because it's thick and it really clings to anything that I'm doing. I have got
what
some
feta is that, Jen?
That's
what
the feta,
feta
that
is
you app. That's your favorite feta, baby.
Oh.
That's the one you adore.
It's very
what feta
creamy.
Is that the Danish feta?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Because you get two types. You get the smooth one and then you get the one that's crumbly.
It's a little bit crumbly, absolutely. So for me, I'm looking for the creamiest consistency I can get. And I'm going to just off the top of my cheese, I'm going to just put the chili in and the pepper. Mm. Because I wanted to infuse my sauce up front. You don't need a lot of chili. I've used dry chili. You can use fresh. And the beauty of this is that before you know it, look, it's already starting to boil. So the minute you see it starting to kick up its feet and give you a couple of bubbles, just take your cheese and just break it into this. Just say you want to make a meat sauce, Jules, and you want to do a steak. Peppercorn. Do you know the Madagascar green peppercorns? You can pop that into this as well. If you feel it's a little bit too thick, you can put a bit of milk with it, just to break it down. But before you know it, I promise you, you're going to have this wonderful creamy sauce. So I'm going to, I love courgettes. There are so many names for these things. Am I right? Give me some other names for these. Courgette, zucchini, a lot of people
call them
baby marrows. Come on.
For me, I was just going to go with zucchini. That's what I usually
zucchini,
call it.
Yes, absolutely. A rose by any other name. Courgette, baby marrow. I love these. And all I've done with these is I've blanched them. And you could make a lovely bake with this, where you just do this and then you stick it into the oven with some cheese on top of it, some yellow cheese of your choice. I like a very strong mature or some pecorino. That lovely Zandam pecorino works nice with this. Do that. If you want to, this makes the most delicious toasted cheese. And you can put yellow cheese, a bit of feta, pack it onto your salmis and stick it under the grill. It's so happy and so would you be. It's really, 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 really nice. So
I'm going to do that.
It's delicious and it just makes a quick dinner. I'm going to take a little bit of pasta. Look at me, Tara, just for you, baby. Doesn't that look sexy?
Amazing.
And I'm going to give this a nice stir. So as I was saying, if you want to put it onto meat, all you need to do is just take some of those beautiful Madagascar peppercorns and just pop it into the pot with this. And you are going to be one happy chappy. So it's not just about the veg.
Does feta actually malt smoothly? I've never actually put feta into a pan and malted it.
No, it does. It melts a good quality one will in a sauce like this, when you do the sauce like this. There are some terrible fetas on the market. They're like cardboard. They're like polyfiller. They're disgusting. They don't crumble. They don't cook. And I want to hit those people who manufacture that. It really breaks my heart that someone thinks they can insult our taste buds and our intelligence by giving us bad product. Have a look. I think I have some
of that cardboard in my fridge. No, that's why I'm so amazed at the smooth feta that you have in front of you.
You get what you pay for, trust me. Okay, so have a look at this. Here's your pasta. I'm going to just give it a little toss. Just look at this. Do you see how beautifully it coats it?
Mm.
This is so quick and so easy. And then you can grate some more Parmesan cheese on it. But I mean, it really, every little piece of this pasta is coated. And I've used like a macaroni, because what happens is the sauce runs right down into it.
This too rich for a mac and cheese?
Never, never. Add it to your mac and cheese. I put an egg there for a very good reason, because it would take some milk and a couple of eggs and beat it into this with some yellow cheese as well. Toss it into your macaroni cheese. Hello, mouth heaven.
I'm making that tonight.
Would you mix the egg and milk separately before you throw it into the pot?
Yes, just beat it up separately and then just whack it together into your pot. Just look at this. Just have a look at this. Does this not look absolutely glorious? Look at that. Look at that. It just coats so beautifully. Can't go wrong. Look at that. And I know you say you don't want lumps, but I like little chunky lumpies of this. And look at that. It's better.
Because in this case, it's lumps of feta and not lumps of flour.
Yes, of flour. Exactly. Because it's nice to get those little chunky bits, you know. And then you could, if you want to, Julian, you could add some bacon bits over the top. You can take some Parmesan cheese and grate it over the top, cheddar cheese, anything you want. And this makes the most beautiful, beautiful dressing for a salad. So you could do a lovely broccoli salad and put blue cheese in this instead of feta, and then over the top. Or you could grill pears and make a lovely pear salad with some honey and some crispy bacon or pancetta. And then use this as a dressing over the top with blue cheese. It's stunning. It's just so easy. How many minutes did that take us? No time at all.
Love
it.
The traditional white sauce, like my wrists are always sore after whisking for so long, and it takes forever, and flour and butter and milk and yeah.
So this one, I also love this on a mealie. And what I do with the mealie is I take some onions and I cook them nice and crisp, and I chop chili into it with some coriander, and I sprinkle it over the top, and I just bite into it. It's so delicious. And you can add a little blob of butter to that at the end if you want to, if you want the butteriness as well. So one sauce, many, many, many applications. It's a lovely way to cheat. Am I right?
Yeah, Tanya is saying making a sauce is therapeutic.
Of course it is.
I get that.
No, when you have time, you have time. Yeah. And a sauce, as I said, depends on what sauce you're making, you know. A cheese sauce, if you're making a white sauce, that takes time, and you need to give it time, because what you need is all those little starch bubbles that are in the flour. You need it to burst, okay? I should do this for St. Patrick's Day. Hello, my little Irish devils. Happy St. Patrick's Day to you all. And to Father Pat, happy St. Patrick's Day. there's many ways to skin a cat, you know. And a white sauce, like we're saying, Josef Peterson, you're quite right. That sauce is the base for so many different sauces. You take that base and you own it and put anything you like in it. And it's just
live on our social media.
Look at you look lovely. Yes, are you back?
Yeah I'm back. Hello, hello. I was watching you on social media. That looked fantastic.
Huh? Easy.
Easy. Easy, yes. Simple, straightforward. Yeah, for anybody who's struggling with a white sauce that you can pile over some broccoli, you can pile it over some meat. I mean, just whatever the sauce. If it is that you're going to do a pasta based dish and you need a white sauce, in no time. I mean, we hardly had played two songs, and there you are, already having whipped it up.
Somebody's talking about coconut milk. How do you feel, Jenny, about coconut milk?
I think it's a marvelous way as well. Just remember that the feta is very salty. It's got more of a Mediterranean feel to it. But who cares? It's your mouth, your recipe, own it. I think it's a lovely idea.
Nice. In fact, somebody a bit earlier saying, I was looking at the comments, making sauce is therapeutic.
It is.
Yeah, so I mean, if you're all stressed out at the end of a long day, you just want to do something, you know, but while you're busy chopping onions and doing whatever else, it's time to get saucy. Cool. Anything going on in Jenny Morris's world that you can share with us?
Yes, please.
Oh my God. Oh no. I wish ek wens ek kan baie goeie Afrikaans praat, because weet jy wat, môre film ek saam met Sally Philander and Wilma. En ons is on a quiz show en ek is in die dang.
In die moeilikheid.
Nee, moeilikheid in die dang. Countdown. Oh, because I hope I understand the questions.
Is it going to be in Afrikaans?
Ja, ek gaan in Afrikaans wees, ja. But I'm also, don't worry, I'll relax on Sunday. We open at Yumptious with some beautiful music and gorgeous Sunday lunch. Well, those are the two things, the highlights.
I've never been scared for anything you've done, Jenny, but I'm petrified for you in this.
So am I, because I direct translate.
Yeah.
I call an ostrich a big bird in Afrikaans. You know what I'm saying? I'm into such trouble. Ooh.
Well, there'll be lots of trouble without Jenny, that's for sure. Listen, good luck, fingers crossed. We'll find out from you next Thursday how that went, okay?
I'll have blood on my face.
There we are. We fooded around this morning with our Jenny Morris. Every Thursday we're live on the socials, also live on the radio. That's the story for this morning. Please do join us again next Thursday right here at Hot Breakfast.